Bye again. All right, so what is the difference between a spec script and a pilot script? Well, both are really important to a writer's portfolio so that you have the proper materials to be able to present to Hollywood and to basically show what you can do. Similar to a graphic designer having a portfolio of designs and maybe some mock ads or things like that, a pilot script and a spec script are exactly those elements for a writer's portfolio. All right, so what is the difference? The pilot script is generally your own idea. It's your own series creation, and it is what anyone who kind of wants to become that series creator and eventual showrunner would have to have. So in the pilot script, you would create your own idea of whatever place you set the series in. So it could be a well-known city like New York or Los Angeles or something along those lines, but it would be your own interpretation. So it would include things like, what's the setting in terms of the year? What is the mood and the tone? There are very many different interpretations that one can make of everywhere you might be. So a good example might be something like Sex and the City, where the setting was, of course, New York City, but the tone and the style of how New York came to life was the interpretation of the creator of the series. So in that case, you would emphasize in your pilot script elements that would be unique to how you interpret that location. Similarly, the characters have to be clearly set out in terms of who they are, what it is that is relatable about them, what is their story. And the story of the character is really important to your pilot, because if anything is going to carry a series well, it's going to be the characters, and especially your main character. So many times in writing, your character arc is very similar to your story arc. And what that means is that in your pilot episode, you should have a clear idea and a clear sense of how your character and potentially then your story begins, the middle of it, and then of course the end or resolution. That full arc of a story comes into play when you're developing your character and when you're developing the story of your pilot episode. Okay, the next parts of your pilot that are really important are things like kind of giving a sense of how future episodes will look. You obviously don't want to give away everything because you want the audience to come back to see what's going to happen, but that's the idea that at least should be laid out in the pilot. The audience should care enough to want to come back and see where those characters are going or where the story might be going as the future episodes come along. Next up is the season arc of your pilot, which you don't really have to get into in your pilot so much, but it's something that you as a writer should be thinking of and maybe even lacing in some thoughts or some hints or some teases in terms of where that all might be going in terms of where your season is going. Now let's talk about the spec script. The spec script is different in that it is a episode of a pre-existing or already existing series. Generally, your spec script needs to be up to date. If you are trying to get a writing job right now, I wouldn't write a spec script of a series that's 10 years old or a series that's no longer being made. And the reason for that is because you want to stay relevant, you want to show that you know what's going on right now, and you want to show your writing style is up to date. So pick a series that is hopefully it has a little bit of life in it and you can kind of get a sense of it. You can read the trades and see what series have been renewed, which series are really popular. But also you have to kind of pick a series that's not too advanced. Something like, you know, the fifth or sixth season of something, because that series might come to a close soon. It's sort of hard to know, of course, but you want to pick something that maybe is in its first year and it's really taken off, or its second year and people have really, really gone, oh my God, this is such an amazing series. And, you know, the ratings are good and the buzz in the media is good, and the actors, of course, have to also be popular, and so that you kind of can gauge if there's some longevity to that series. So once you've chosen the series you want to write a spec for, then obviously study that series as best as you can. Study and read up on what the creator is saying about it, what the actors might be saying about the series, and whatever you can get your hands on. That will help you to craft what is a engaging episode, one that will impress people who might be either associated with the series or familiar with it, and really show off what kind of writing abilities you have in that spec script. So you want to marry and mirror the tone and the style of the series. You want to make sure that the characters sound like the characters that already have been created. If a character, for example, is a very serious character, you may not want to experiment too much and make them comedic suddenly. You can certainly breathe new life into the characters in your own way, but you wouldn't want to deviate beyond the characters that have been pre-established. What you're showing a series creator is that you can write for them, that you can actually write an episode that could be made, and that you are enhancing the series, not taking away. All right, so essentially those are the differences between what a spec script is and what a pilot script is. I'm referring mostly to hour-long dramas in what I'm talking about right now, but what I've talked about is applicable to comedies and any and all sorts of different series that are currently going on and can help in showing that you're serious, that you really mean business, that you want this career as a writer in Hollywood, right? So happy writing. It can be a laborious process, but hopefully you'll enjoy it and get yourself a wonderful portfolio of your writing abilities. Okay, thanks for watching. Please click subscribe and like, and I'll see you in the next video.